I'm into the voucher system. I think we need competition in the school. The public schools, what they do is they don't have any competition, so they have a status quo. If we gave the kids vouchers and we had, hey, this kid, every year you get a voucher, you can go pick your school. It'd be private, public, homeschooling, whatever, that voucher would go to that, and that would bring competition within the schools, and that would, right there, would produce a better education because, I mean, you have competition. When you have competition, you're going to do the best work you can. When you're just sitting there and you're doing the status quo and you're fine with it and everything's doing, that's where we're having problems. And we do need major help with our education. And I do want to promote private schooling and homeschooling. I'm very big on homeschooling. Homeschooling has the best education rate. The people that have SAT scores, homeschooling, they're the top rated, followed by private schooling. And then, unfortunately, public schooling is lacking.
I believe the best long-term investment we can make in the future of this state is in expanding early childhood education to give every child at least a chance to start kindergarten prepared to succeed. And I believe we have a lot of kids in Nebraska right now who aren't getting what they need at home, and so they start kindergarten so far behind that the odds are against them ever succeeding in school. And I believe we all have a stake in fixing that. Because if those kids don't succeed in school, they're not going to contribute to our state's prosperity. They're going to cost us in prisons, in public assistance, and in other ways.
Well, I think that when it comes to how do we make sure kids get a great education, because that's what we want to do is improve those educational outcomes for all of our kids. As I've mentioned, my top priority is going to be career and vocational training. When it comes to early childhood, certainly, there's more work that we can do. You know, I worked with the inner city Catholic schools, and I know that low-income kids often come to school that they haven't been read to, they may have counseling needs, they may have nutritional needs. It's hard to learn on an empty stomach. And so there's things we can do. But we've also seen a lot of the early childhood development programs don't have lasting effects. What I would like to do is look at what other states have done. For instance, Susana Martinez in New Mexico has focused just on reading, pre-K through third grade, that times when children are learning to read. Because if you don't do that, if you don't learn to read, you can't read to learn thereafter. And so that's where I would like to focus on how we make sure those kids are getting those great education by focusing on those things early on.